Here we have cool graphics. Smooth movement. Bullet shots in all directions. Enemies attacking the main character. The random movement of enemies. Collision detection. Now let us go into the technical details of the project. This is the high level diagram of the game. The central part is the game logic, and all the other modules are coordinated within the game logic. In the top part we have a VGA controller, and we use the sprite BRAM for displaying various images. On the left hand side we have the random number generator, which is used for random generation of enemies. We use the keyboard for the entire game control, and we also use the audio core for playing sound. Here are the main functionalities of our game. So it is based on the 1980s classic arcade style shooting game. The spaceship has to pass through various enemies, and as you can look at the main specifications of our game, we have a USB keyboard. Then we also have a P-mode audio output. We have a VGA controller for displaying various images. This is the game logic diagram. The game enters into the start mode once we press the reset button. There is a game control which is provided by the keyboard. Then we have the collision detection. So whenever there is a collision, I pass the coordinates to the VGA. We also have various timers. After every 1 second, we increment the score by 10, and after every 5 seconds, the AI module turns on. Then we also check the number of lives. So the game gets over whenever number of lives turn to 0. Here is the state diagram of the system. So it basically explains the transition of levels. We have kept it according to the scores. So whenever scores go to a specific point, the level transition occurs, and there is a reset state. So whenever there is a game over, we can start the game again by pressing the reset key.
Now I'm going to talk about my enemy AI system. In enemy AI system, I have included a random bit generation, which was learned in class using LFSR, and generate the enemy spawn positions and also the enemy move, also included into the enemy movements. In the enemy movements, I include two parts. One is from the random bit generation, and also is another part is from the deterministic, like that is pre-stored inside of the Verilog code, that is deterministic movements. So in the part of the deterministic movements, I first use position generation, MATLAB code to generate a position.txt file. In that file, I store all the positions of this movement and include that into the Verilog code. So in this process, we just need to write down one line of code. It's very simplified. And for this MATLAB code, it's universally applied to any kinds of function that you want to generate. For example, in the future, probably someone else want to come up with another kind of function that, a kind of movement that you want. You can first just write down the function for that movement. For example, sometimes I use sine waveform, sometimes I use the triangle form, and include that into one line of the MATLAB code that I'm gonna show you to you. So that I use this to generate this txt file, as I said, and then include that into the Verilog code. It's very convenient. So I'm just giving an example of the combination of this deterministic movement combined with the random generation. So what I'm going to show you is the enemy tracking down the character movement. Usually we do this, it's like using the exact same Y position for the enemy to the character. So if we did that, the enemy will be always in front of the character so that the character can never pass through that. In order to like keep this fun and while still can make the players to succeed pass through the enemy, we're just trying to use a lag time for the reaction time. as you can see from this graph, for the time that is lag behind, we use the 4 to 3 bits from the random generation, so that make this lag time like random generated, so that this kind of thing does not like happening like a fixed pattern, so that keeps more fun for the game.
This is a MATLAB code for generation of the positions. And as you can see, there are several lines that I have commented out. For those lines is the function that is for the deterministic positions of the enemies. The future users can replace those functions with the functions they like. And that's how that we are going to generate those TXT files that could be included in the Verilog code. And this is a Verilog code for including the two TXT files. It is very easy, just using two lines of code. So it is like customized way of doing this deterministic positions.
Start. Let us say we want to make the image like this using the color effect. Then first step would be to modify the properties and make it the size of the image you want. Let's say you want like 150 by 138. Then your image will look like this. You need to zoom it down. Firstly, select the pencil, and maybe you can have the grid lines included. And you can just use the hand creativity to convert to make a tower.
I'll talk about the motion of the sprites. For moving the sprites, the motion of the sprites should be synchronized with the screen refresh rate. So how do we calculate the refresh rate? It is calculated by this formula, which is given by VGA clock divided by maximum value of the horizontal pixel counter into maximum value of the vertical counter. The VGA clock is given by 25 MHz, and the HMAX and VMAX are given as 800 and 525 respectively. So by keeping these values in this formula, we get the refresh rate of 59.52 Hz, which is approximately 60 Hz. Now if you want to calculate the counter for the motion, let us go here and see how the counter for the motion is calculated. So the formula is HMAX into VMAX divided by 2. And keeping on the values of HMAX and VMAX, we get the value which is 2,10,000. But when we keep the exact value, it does not give the good motion. Yeah. It shows the flickering. So by trying different values above this, I got the exact value, which is 2,25,000, where the motion was perfectly fine. All my things were moving perfectly fine.
According to prior explanation, I chose the counter value such that the movement of sprites is smooth enough. We wanted to have completely smooth background, but we faced one more problem. The image, when it reaches to the end, it would disappear. To solve this problem, we switched all of our pixel coordinates to be sign register. This allowed graphics to be continue out of screen boundaries and have negative coordinates. This is the another land of the background we have, but we were not able to integrate it because of the resource constraint.
In order to pilot his spaceship, Deval needed a keyboard controller. With every press and release, the keyboard streams out data synchronized to its clock. The keyboard scanner module triggers on this clock and extracts the 8-bit key code sent. When a key is pressed, it sends a unique identifying code, and when a key is released, it sends a generic release signal along with the unique code indicating that key which was released. The keyboard decoder module receives data from the scanner and then determines based on the release flag whether to set or release the game control signals such as the up, down, shoot, or other controls. Here goes Deval on his way to avenge the universe. My original concept for this sound design for this game was to stream high-resolution audio waveforms. I chose the wave audio format because it is not a compressed sound, so it has much higher quality. This also makes it much easier to directly access the data. whereas other files such as MP3 would first have to go through several stages of decoding and filtering to become usable. This MATLAB function audio read will give you a list of all the samples of a WAV file. The default value will return normalized values between plus and minus 1 of type double, or you can use the option native to import as assigned a 16-bit integer, which would be more useful for processing in the FPGA. This plot shows the waveforms, and as we zoom in, you can see the individual samples that you would receive. If you choose to pursue this approach of audio, be sure to get the correct PMOD device.